Day 76, hazy light, casting faint patterns on the walls of my cramped cabin aboard the Nostromo, my whole reclamation ship. My mind, weary from the grind and the weight of responsibility in a notoriously dangerous icy asteroid ring system, infested with murder hobos, murderers, and ship gankers. I want to resist the call to wakefulness, but duty demands my presence and I need to check systems which are standard operating procedures on waking from a bedlog. As is my way, the ship is empty of crew, as I like to maximize my profits. Through honed habit I listen for a while, feeling the hum of my vast ship, letting the tingle of artificial gravity play at my feet. All seems good, but until I get to the bridge I won't be able to confirm. The rocks outside can crack a reclaimer wide open or cause other more insidious damage that over time can be just as deadly. It's always incredibly beneficial to take some well-deserved chill time before diving into the tasks at hand even after waking. I find it imperative at the start of a working day to first create a frame of mind that is calm and collected. Out here, one single mistake can swiftly lead to a devastating and miserable game over. Calm attained, it's time to make vast amounts of UEC, which stands for United Earth Credits. Heading to the bridge. Long live the United Empire of Earth. Just an OCD moment from living in a pressurized hunk of metal with a varying mass of around 9 million kilograms for months at a time. I like to do checks. The crew areas are nothing special, but they are not meant to be, and that is not a slight on the crew or their importance. If you get too comfortable, you can become complacent and immune to the dangers out here. As a loner, the only life I have to be concerned with is my own, which is just the way I like it. Losing a ship and all the crew is no joke. Gravity generator is healthy and spinning in its cycle. It is so beautiful close up that it can become mesmerizing to gaze at. On Hurston and even New Babbage, quite a community pays monthly for the live streaming of a Class 3 gravity generator. 2954 is a crazy time. Let the games commence. This is the main control node, the nervous system, the sensors, and defensive weapons stations with single access to the surface via an elevator. Most apart from the main dorsal turret is all accessed from here, but with no crew, I take the risks alone, and the profits too. First things first, nourish yourself. Maintaining stable blood sugar levels is paramount in this artificial gravity environment, where fluctuations can occur rapidly. I might as well have a beer, something with a little kick to start the day. It's like that ancient saying goes, if no one can see you drink the beer in single control of a massive starship, are any rules actually broken? No. Here we go.
Aegis combat system activated. Systems green.
Sensors are clear, just rocks. I prefer to avoid pinging the area just in case it draws attention in this little sector of the dark forest. A fat reclaimer trying to hide, it is more effective than you might think. Some damage to the main dorsal turret. Presumably caused by a collision, perhaps with a rock. Appears to have jammed an actuator, as it's whacked right now and won't be useful if I encounter the nefarious out here. Not a great start. Yella's rings are composed primarily of water ice with trace amounts of other materials, such as precious metals, dust, and rocky particles. These particles range in size from tiny grains to vast mountain-sized monsters. The ice in Yella's rings is largely made up of water ice, although there are many other compounds mixed in as well. If you are not an experienced pilot, this is a very dangerous place. The wreck is a beauty, all ripe and ready for the taking just so long as I stay one step of the rapidly approaching contracted security. There is more than enough time to eat this up and depart the area. A near pristine constellation Andromeda, ripe for hull stripping. I believe it's time to utilize a handheld device to gather materials, just in case the damage to the dorsal turret proves reparable, though I won't hold my breath right now. No pun intended. It's about to get dangerous. So focus like the warrior you are. A saying my dad told me. Thanks, Dad. Preparing for extravehicular activity, undoubtedly my least favorite aspect of the job, but a necessary one nonetheless. Never underestimate the importance of your helmet. Even in this advanced age, accidents happen, and pilots still leave airlocks without a helmet because they are distracted by a heavy workload. Venturing into the vacuum of space without proper headgear is a perilous oversight. Space's unforgiving environment wreaks havoc on the body, causing tissue swelling, embolism, and ultimately, a grim demise. When in doubt, double check, even triple check. In space, a single error often proves fatal. I was already aware of the damage to the dorsal turret, but seeing it smashed beyond repair is never a pleasant sight. Nevertheless, since I'm already out here, I'll engage in some scraping work, if only for its therapeutic benefits. The Cambio SRT, salvage and repair tool, from Greycat Industrial is a specialized handheld device designed for salvaging and performing rapid repairs on vehicles. This versatile tool is capable of collecting and converting alloys and polymers from scrap materials into recycled composite materials, which can be sold or utilized for swift repairs. I should be able to repair at least some of that turret with what I salvage here. Dealing with an explosive decompression because I left a turret flapping in the wind, metaphor obviously, is to be avoided. Sometimes, the most calming activity out here is hull stripping. There's a certain satisfaction in knowing that every moment translates into earnings, all while stockpiling composite and polymers for future repairs your ship might need. In this vast expanse, devoid of pit stops and fraught with potential dangers from strangers, it's a reassuring endeavor. The greatest advantage of working and living alone out here is the abundant time for contemplation. While conversation has its merits, humans can often be likened to cats, notoriously difficult to herd. They desire to make plans, engage in chatter, or ask questions you may not be inclined to respond to. Silence is golden in an environment constantly seeking to end you in a million different ways. For self-preservation reasons, I much prefer if chatter is limited to crucial matters such as, "Oh no, my suit has a leak." Or, "Oh no, I'm dying." Or, "Oh no, boss, I think we have company," topics of that nature. I don't mean to come across as unempathetic, but time is credits, not got time for jibber jabber. Anyway. The primary resource, of course, is CM, or construction materials. These are acquired by initially breaking down a ship using a powerful electromagnetic field, echoing the wisdom of Nikola Tesla from the 20th century. He famously stated, "If you wish to understand the universe, look at energy and vibration." How right he was. Scanning and identification. My reclaimer boasts advanced scanning systems that aid in pinpointing potential salvage targets in the vastness of space. Once a suitable target is located, I evaluate its condition and assess its value, whilst also scanning for potential dangerous contacts. Refining and storage. Salvaged materials necessitate further refinement or processing before they are fit for storage or sale. My reclaimer is outfitted with state-of-the-art refining facilities and ample storage capacity, ensuring that salvaged materials are processed and stored efficiently until they can be transported to suitable destinations for sale or utilization. To be fair, I packed those 16 SCU boxes and like a bomb went off. It's quick and maximizes profit. Always set your processors to 16 standard cargo units. It's the most efficient way to make profits, and that is the only reason I am out here. Salvaging hammerheads becomes second nature, and after a while, you no longer bother keeping count. As long as there's storage space, I'll continue fracturing and disintegrating holes until I can't stand it any longer. Disassembly, valuable alloys, polymers, and components, such as intact weapons, engines, and electronics, are atomized within a powerful field, drawing out raw materials like metals and alloys, gathered for subsequent refining and processing, slurping it all up. Occasionally, I encounter a malfunctioning ship, a malfunction that forces a crew to set a rescue beacon and leave the area after a pickup. I see these rare encounters as a welcome break from the grind, and thus I tend to search for an access point because you never know what they might have left behind. But if it's still powered up, I'm not going to be able to enter, and shooting the ship open is going to get me a crime status. These are measures, standard security measures on all ships. But sometimes you strike it lucky, and you find an open docking port. It's a Retaliator, a warship. One that carries a powerful payload of military-grade weapons. Take a periodic risk and safety assessment and decide to head for the gas world and the floating city of Orizon for repairs to the dorsal turret because the dorsal turret packs the biggest punch and it's causing me anxiety. Orizon, it's a nice place, nice weather, but don't fall into the lower layers, there is an active ecosystem down there, and you would not like it.